So Dr. Kennedy, you've been our team doctor for 3 years. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, it's been a really great experience. I was fortunate enough to do that through our residency program, and I've really enjoyed working with the team and with the athletic trainers.
Now, the real question is, do you still get tested?
Yes, we get tested all of the time, so a little bit less than in college, but in residency, when we were doing our training to be a pediatrician, we had one big test every year and then like several smaller tests like every 3 or 4 months. And then now, even though I'm done with residency, we have one big test coming up. Mine's next week. It's 9 hours long, and we get to do that every 10 years. But in between, we have to keep doing all these like maintenance of educations to make sure we stay up to date on everything, and it's about every 3 months.
So, Sergeant, can you tell us a little bit about what you do in testing?
Yeah, start with just to become a police officer. You start by taking a test. There's a 100-question multiple choice test, and you actually have to get a 70 or better just to move on to the next part. And our testing is not just academic. From there, you actually have to go take a physical fitness test. Once you get hired on by the police department next, if you want to move on to a detective bureau, or if you want to test and be part of our SWAT team or any other specialty squad, the air unit, things like that, it's another process. You have to study. You have to meet with people, do a lot of homework and stuff in order to do well in the process and hopefully get there. Same thing to promote to sergeant, lieutenant, commander, things like that. It's another test. There's a essay portion that we have to write for both the sergeant and the lieutenant's process. And there's multiple choice tests as well as oral boards. So there's a lot of studying involved and a lot of hard work in order to advance your career.
So you're the manager at Jack in the Box, and your employees might think, oh gosh, you know, we don't have to test anymore, but what are the kind of testings they have to do in order to work here?
They still need to watch videos and do the training guides and stuff like that to meet the standards so that we'll know they're qualified to work here.
Now, what kind of testing do you need to take in order to become a manager?
Testing, like for assistant manager, you need to take the CERSAVE, you need to watch videos, and CERSAVE is about 90 questions. You have to get above 80%.
Back when I started 15 years ago, you would attend training and it was one of those, you assign a roster, you're there, and you know, that's all it was. Nowadays, there's a lot more emphasis on making sure that we've learned the topics. So there's usually an assessment or some kind of a test after the training, just to ensure that we didn't just show up and basically not pay attention. So it's definitely evolved a lot over my career, the 15 years so far, and it's become a lot more of a, they're pushing more for college graduates and things like that in our field, so they want more of the educated people who are taking it serious like a professional career.
Wow, that's amazing. Now, do you think you're ever going to finish testing?
Yeah, probably when I retire.
So you graduated from high school, and did you think like, oh, we don't have to take us any test anymore?
Yeah, I was actually surprised about that because like I thought it was just going to be just work, 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 but it goes with the job. The more you know, the better, the more you're worth.